Well, now for the very final session, we will have a panel discussion on where does the Delhi NCR OOH business go from here, way forward goals. And to take this discussion forward, I welcome on stage Mr. Pramod Bhandula, Executive Chairman, JC Deco, India, Mr. Pawan Bansal, CEO, Jagran Engage, Mr. Amit Kapoor, Director, US Advertising. Welcome. Thank you. Yes. Mr. Dipankar Sanyal, you're here? Oh, yes. I was looking for you. Thank you for joining us. Well, we had a long day, but a very, very engaging discussion right through, different perspectives. We just had a session where there were so many fresh thoughts, lots of action points. This session will, in a sense, encapsulate all of the different points that were taken up for discussion. And we have a very, very good panel out here to take this forward. And of course, I've given myself the privilege of asking the questions so that the discussion gets started. So what I'll do is I have put down a few questions, taking the cues from the various presentations that were made during the day, and I will just field those questions to each one of you and seek your views on that. Well, starting with the very theme of the conference, we said that it's not going to be Delhi talks, it's going to be Delhi NCR. So the whole geography, the reference point changes. So we're talking about the Delhi NCR market. One aspect, one observation that I had right through the day was that the NCR was forgotten. It was Delhi all the way. So my question to, I'd like to start with Pawan. And Pawan, is Delhi NCR really the market to address, or is it still Delhi? Why am I'm asking this question is because there are fundamental differences in the way media is regulated, how the opportunities come up. If you look at Delhi, you look at Noida, you look at Gurgaon. I mean, Delhi NCR is a considerably large geography. So how do you really look at Delhi NCR as a market? Do you really address it in that sense, or is it predominantly Delhi?
Rajiv, I think most of the brands and well as the agencies who are working on the outdoor plans, now Delhi no more is Delhi per se, it is Delhi NCR. So whenever the briefs are coming to us or when the plans are being made by the media owners, it is basically we are addressing Delhi NCR. So you talk about Noida, you talk about Gurgaon, you talk about Faridabad, you talk about Delhi. So per se, not many brands are saying we want only Delhi. It's a mix of Delhi, Gurgaon, and Noida, and to an extent, Faridabad. So I think so brands have started realizing that Delhi itself has expanded into the NCR region. So that is why it's called the NCR region now. So most of the briefs, Dipankar, correct me if I'm wrong, most of the briefs are now coming for Delhi NCR only. So it is not per se Delhi, okay? Second, I think so, also the fact that media in Delhi is very exorbitant, okay? So recently what we have seen is that a lot of monies are being pushed out of Delhi into NCR. So if you go to Noida, you'll see brands where campaigns are not being advertised in Delhi actually, but you can see them on outdoor in Noida or in Gurgaon. The third fact is also, yes, as correctly said, that all the three regions, all the three cities have a different outdoor policy,
yes.
Correct? In fact, we were discussing before this panel that why can't we have a single currency in terms of single policy for the Delhi NCR region? because Delhi itself has now three corporations,
yes,
three different policies actually. Okay, forget about Gurgaon and Noida. So I guess if Delhi NCR can have a single policy, it would make a hell of a difference actually in terms of media is being developed here. Okay, so that is my view.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. I'll go to Dipankar because he's from the planning and buying perspective. When you're dealing with brands and we're talking about the opportunities and the reason to be here, how do you approach them with the Delhi NCR story as opposed to Delhi?
Very frankly, see, in my two decades of my experience with outdoor, one thing that has remained very constant, very frankly, is when you're doing a budgeting for, say, a pan-India campaign, it comes to a Mumbai-Delhi kind of scenario, it's always 40% put in Mumbai, 25% to 30% put in Delhi. Okay. Now comes the next phase of it when I'm coming to Delhi. Again, when I'm talking about Delhi, South Delhi mein le lena and Gurgaon mein dekhna kuch bada site mil jaye and Noida mein dekh lena. So this is what I'm talking from an advertiser from a point of view who is not based out of Delhi. Okay.
Yes.
Almost 30% of Delhi's outdoor is being consumed by Mumbai clients for that matter. So it's a huge amount, right? And this is the perspective with which they're working. So it is very niche in their mind. It's very niche that these are the two places that if you cover, you have done it kind of thing. So
the Delhi NCR as a reality hasn't really kicked in as yet, it looks like. Is it so, Mr. Bhandula?
See, rightly Pawan was talking about until unless we have one policy for all the entire region, NCR, this problem will remain really, you know. And I'll go further to add that, still we, Delhi as a NCR, are different markets, rest of the country if you take it. It's not a complete billboard city like we have in Bombay or Calcutta. Delhi have a different, a particular South Delhi when he's talking, definitely I agree with him that each and every client, they will go for Central Delhi and South Delhi and rest 5-10% East Delhi, North Delhi, you just spread it across. Gurgaon, of course, being a corporate hub, everybody wants to have here. Even in Noida, if you take, there's only particular sector 18 around two malls. And beyond that, you will not find even a single brand spread across. So this challenge is there for this particular area, NCR area, which is going to stay for some more time. It's now what I feel that with the IOA, the initiatives, what now with the Delhi chapter, we have to lobby, we have to take it up with the higher authorities to really address those issues. One, I definitely really salute you. You were talking really, really outdoor. I think you should be this side, really. Some of the key things you talked about was like long durations, uniformity, less for more kind of things which you were talking. These all things really NCR needs very badly, very badly. And if you have to increase the pie, as we all are concerned really being the industry, we have to address those issues. And IO chapter and IO is really, really going to play a vital role in that in the coming years. Secondly, my concern is really, you know, if we as a country and then as a city, as a responsible OOH industry, if we have to get a good recognition, which we really lacking a bit, but we have to work hard on it to really regain. We have to create a showcase. We have to create a showcase in Delhi NCR. I mean, it's very important. At least one city, if we can create as a showcase for OOH, rest even this all upcoming smart cities can follow those, really. So that is what some of the really key concerns and goals we have in front of us to address.
Thank you. I'll go to Mr. Amit Kapoor and ask him the same question. That, you know, if it looks like Delhi NCR looks like a little bit forced as an idea, right? So should we really continue with it? Or why not look at all of these different constituents differently? I know, I understand the point that at one time you had only one MCD to deal with, now there are three of them. And on top of that, we are including Gurgaon and Noida. And so is it becoming a little unwieldy to look at Delhi NCR as a geography or as a market? Why not leave them all separately and position each one strongly?
See, the way people are commuting between Delhi and NCR, so Delhi NCR has to be treated as one. Person who is staying in Noida might be working in Gurgaon or vice versa. And if you have to target everybody, then it has to be treated as one. And when the budget comes or when the brief comes from the client, Delhi NCR is always treated as one. Specifically, now Gurgaon is getting a more mileage because of the corporates being present there and the kind of TG shifting from South Delhi. And South Delhi, Gurgaon is treated as an extension of South Delhi. That is why it has got some value more than the other parts of NCR. And the second would come as a Noida. And then after that, Ghaziabad, which is always lost in the campaign, ki ek side laga dena, value so less, to value add mein bhi lag jati hai. So that covers it as a NCR. But technically, when we talk Delhi NCR, that it, even if we say Delhi, it means NCR.
All right. So I think somewhere along the panel believes that I think we must persist with the idea of Delhi NCR. And
It's seamless right now. It's seamless.
No, it's seamless, Pawan. But when it look at the business, it doesn't look like that. I mean, that's the kind of feeling.
So uniformity. You can talk about uniformity. Uniformity might not be the same in terms of the quality of assets and everything. But also though, in terms of infrastructure, if you see, like Amit said, that when people are commuting, so how do you differentiate? So I think so it has to be treated as a single market. And from the brand's perspective, nothing better than addressing three states at one time, yeah? You're addressing Haryana, UP and Delhi at the same time.
All right. What we've seen over the last 10, 15 years is that infrastructure development in this particular region, more than any other part of the country, has been quite remarkable. And infrastructure development is obviously one very, very important part when it comes to OOH development. So all of those players who are doing business in this particular region should consider themselves supremely lucky that that kind of infrastructure has happened. The second part of the story is one of regulation. All said and done, you may have a lot of differences with the way the policies have come through, but nonetheless, there's a policy in place. There's a lot less uncertainty with regard to what the policies mean in Delhi versus a lot of the other parts. So infrastructure development has taken place, policies are in place, regulation is fairly evident. But the big question is, has the OOH industry changed its business approach? Is it any different from the way it has been doing business for the last 20 years? So, I think I'd like to start with Mr. Bhandula. He has got more experience than anybody out here. So, really, Mr. Bhandula, I would really like you to, you know, comment on this one.
We as industry really very concerned about it. Very, very concerned about the new policy which has just been really being implemented. And still, there are a lot of hiccups in that. Like, you know, out of three corporations, only one corporation is following it, and the rest two are not. So that's a big challenge. And we as an industry have to really wake up and to see to it that it's gets implemented the way it has been drafted. That's one. Two, it's again coming back to the same thing, like, you know, it's very important for all of us, as an industry, that if we seriously be after it, regular follow-ups and make it happen, we have to make it happen. It's all good for us, all of us, industry. And I'm pretty sure under these regulations, if you have law regulations, follow them religiously, 100%, everybody is going to really have its place and going to grow. There's nothing to be frightened about it, like, you know, I'm big, somebody is small or medium or whatever size it is. If you follow regulations, you are bound to grow. And which I feel like, you know, if we have to create a showcase, that is the only way to approach. There is nothing else. And the brand building, the the kind of image building we have to have that will go along, really. These all put together is going to be very crucial, very important for this industry. And let's accept the change. Let's accept the change. We should not be really, living into what we have been doing in last 20 years, 30 years, typical billboards. See, format is a format. It can be a billboard, it can be a small format, it can be a large format. We are hitting now, as rightly said in the previous session, the rest part of the world is already getting 44% of space into digitization. And here in our new policy, again, it doesn't allow us to have digital billboards on the road. And you can have inside the market, but you can't have on the road. All over the world, you all have been traveling across. I mean, you hit everywhere. It's everything is getting digitized. One way, the government of India is promoting digitization, and the municipal corporation and others are still living into the times back and saying no digital billboards on the. So these are a couple of challenges still with the new policy, and we have to address as the time really goes.
Pawan, I'd like to ask you the same question. Yeah. Is that every business? It's not just out of home business. A variety of businesses tend to operate with certain constraints. It's not a perfect situation for any business to work in, right? If that was, that would have been great. So out of home business also encounters many of these challenges. But the situation, as I mentioned, has changed. Infrastructure has developed, regulatory environment has improved, if it's not still the best. Has the business really altered its approach to present itself in the best form?
Yeah, so if you see South Delhi Municipal Corporation as an example, we are talking about fragmentation in the industry, small players, too much fragmented, the industry is too much fragmented, yeah, okay. I think so, Delhi is the best example of consolidation which has happened in the recent past, actually, if you see, especially South Delhi Municipal Corporation. Now there are only 5-6 operators. The clusters were well defined. Yes, we did a mistake. We went and created harakiri by outbidding in the process of outbidding each other. We bid very high, and nobody is making money in that business. But at least that consolidation happened at one point of time. Yeah. So I guess it will happen eventually. And like Mr. Bhandula said, that although the policy envisages that you can push digital media, but it's still restricted to marketplaces, not. You can't really put it on the roads, okay? As far as my organization is concerned, yes, we have adapted. The infrastructure has grown beautifully. We have actually bid for the metro line from Akshardham to Dwarka. It's doing fantastically well. We also bid for the South Delhi Unipol clusters. So these opportunities will keep on coming up. I think so. We have to really decide at what margins we need to operate these tenders if they are coming up. Okay, and at what price we have to pick up these tenders? That is the crucial point. If we are able to address that, and that we have to address as the stakeholders in the industry.
Yes.
Yeah. So because if we are in the process of outbidding each other, I think so nobody's going to make money in this business. Yeah.
Right.
Because the media is getting exorbitantly pricey. Brands are not willing to say that for a 2010 Unipol, I need to pay 7 lakhs in Delhi. Yeah.
Yes.
That's getting out of hand right now. So I think so. The monies are being pushed out to smaller cities like Noida or Faridabad or Gurgaon. Not many brands are really interested in investing in Delhi as of now.
Dipankar, you have immense experience in this industry, and more particularly to this region. Do you see a difference in approach when you are actually doing business with the media owners?
Over the last 3-4 years, yes, there has been a drastic change. There has been a huge change, I would say. And ever since this thing of, four or five players coming into the market, a consolidation is happening. Yes, the way business happens, it has changed quite a bit. Outlook toward, even from advertiser point of view, from agency point of view, our outlook has changed towards them. There is a lot more confidence that has been built. Yes, there are a lot of positives that has happened. So, I mean, just to quote you a figure, if you look at the growth of Mumbai versus Delhi year on year in the 2016 to 2017 year on date, it has been, Delhi has been second, and the growth has been almost to the tune of 30%, but that's not on volume, but because of the price rise might be that has happened. But there has been a growth, which means, yeah, people are accepting it, people are pushing for it, but there are challenges, of course.
Right. Coming to the media ownership part, and also for a fact that it's not just holdings that are the only media to focus upon, especially with this transit media coming into the picture in a big way, it has thrown up a lot of opportunities. But the big question is that given that although there is a certain level of consolidation, but certainly there's still market is fairly fragmented. So if you want to chase up some big projects and the firms are not big enough for that, and if consolidation does not come through, then is there a way that the players can actually come together in some form of a consortia and work? I would request Mr. Kapoor to comment on this one. Is that, would you consider working together with certain other firms as a consortium and actually go for big projects?
I'm already doing it.
You're doing that?
Could you just
elaborate on that?
The South Delhi principal, what we have, everybody has been quoting, since they have been the only corporation who has been able to execute the policy strictly, and that is why if we are surviving those unipoles till now, it's just because the policies has been strict and they've implemented well. And we are already working in a JV with Pioneer. Everybody knows that we are working in a JV with Pioneer. And that's the way forward. And on coming back to your earlier question at how in 20 years the OOH has been changing, in last couple of years, I would like to answer Mr. Kapoor's question he was saying. Now everybody is trying to bring science behind these rates. Now when we are buying these unipoles at such a high cost, and when we go to the client and say this unipole at 20 by 10 has to be sold at a 7 lakh rupees, but then we have to come and give him a number also that these are the impressions which are going to come, and this is the per eyeball cost, and this is how you will compare this with a print or a digital or this kind of a thing. So now the evolution is happening that everybody is trying to get science behind these numbers so that we become an organized sector and we get some credibility to our lives.
I'd like to ask Mr. Bhandula, and I feel that you might come up with a counterpoint, is that given the fragmentation, of course, one way is to work as a, come together as a consortium and look and you know, take up the projects. The other is to have big players such as yours that would actually look at exclusive rights. Is that if there is a media opportunity, you should be the sole, all the rights should belong to you and nobody else. That you may not relish the idea of actually coexisting with other players such that you're not able to optimize the opportunity. From that standpoint, could you just comment on the exclusivity of media rights and how does it work?
That's the key. Yep. That's the key. That's what my question was to DMRC boss, that when are you planning to have one partner for your entire...
No, it hasn't worked as yet, and that must be a reason why they're parceling it out.
That's what I'm coming back to you. Like, it's bound to happen. All the mature markets you look at across the globe is the same fundamentals which works really. One airport, one partner. Of course, in India, so many airports, one partner is working. Is working so well, and it really generates a win-win situation for both of them. You create a competition of 20, 30 people. Nobody's going to really win on that. Neither the principal, neither the players. They half the way they will run out, and you're killing. It's a killing machine, really. You know, you can't continue like this. We are in transition. We are developing economy. I'm pretty sure we are running fast. Let's take that way. I mean, it's not that we are behind or our pace is low. I think it's a matter of couple of years, really. You know, when we are talking smart cities and all other opportunities, transportation, which is going to come up every. City, 1 million plus city is going to have metro, what the government of India is talking about. So opportunities are in abundance, really. It's, I feel today OOH in India is a virgin market. Forget whatever the billboard country used to be in. It is not going to be. It's a matter of maybe another 5 to 10 years. I feel like, you know, I felt 10 years back when we launched JC Tucker in India, I was very optimistic, like, you know, maybe in five years to 10 years, my projection was that I'll be in 10 cities. But I think it was wrong. But now I feel the pace is catching up, really, you know. It's the time. You have to be a bit patient, and consolidation is bound to happen. It will happen.
Pawan, would you share a similar view? Is exclusivity a great idea for you to do business?
Yes, I think so. And as Mr. Bhandula said, that it helps both the parties. Once, so, but we are also looking at open to look at consortiums. Yeah, where there are big tenders and everything, we can look at consortiums. That's not an issue. But yes, exclusivity is of the essence. Yeah. So instead of saying that 5 or 6 people or 10 people will operate the DMRC line, I think so both the partners benefit in that way. You would have heard about the London Metro going at about £1.6 billion for 10 years. Yeah, that's the amount of money that London Metro has generated. Yeah, and that's one single party. That's one single party. Yeah. So one point.
Someday soon. Someday soon it'll happen.
Yeah.
Dipankar, from a buying perspective, how does it work for you in a scenario where actually there are firms that have total exclusive rights? Somewhere along, is that going to put you at a disadvantage?
No, I think that's a boon.
Is that so?
Absolutely. See, at the end of the day, the concept of buying by using multiple vendors for the same thing, it doesn't work at the end of the day. I mean, it's in the advertiser's mind that it's working, but actually it doesn't work. Okay? So it's one vendor, one agency, one client. It makes a lot of difference. Everybody is in a winning position. They make money, we make money, client gets the best value. Right? Otherwise, what happens is, for one, you're bidding 10 people. I mean, there's so much of uncertainty, right? So it doesn't help. It's better to have that.
Okay, I'll just take this discussion to a subject which is debatable. Of course, everything is debatable, but this particular one may be a little, it might just throw different views. It's about the media owners and agencies really working together. That is not very, very evident. In a sense, sometimes they seem to be at cross purposes. Very recently, Indian Outdoor Advertising Association and the AAAI have come together to agree on the SOP. But my question is that it has taken 2 years of discussion. There are problems there, right? If it takes 2 years to come to an agreement on this aspect, how many more years would it take to actually take it forward? Pawan.
Difficult question to answer, but what I feel is, I think so more or less now people have reached an agreement saying that now agencies are on board, the media owners are on board. So it's, I was always of the opinion that it's not only the agencies who are at fault, it's sometimes the media owners are also at fault. And I think so that common ground has been reached. I think so within the next 12 months, I see the landscape changing in terms of the SOP implementation. Yeah.
Okay.
So I think so it will not take, so it took us 2 years to actually put pen to paper, but I guess in the next 12 months, we should be well on our way to get this thing implemented. Yes, it will have teething problems in the beginning, but I think so if people like Dipankar and Suresh and Nobendu and Haresh, they are on board for implementing this, I think so should happen as soon as possible. Yeah.
Dipankar.
Yeah. If I take OAC itself as a platform, where this discussion has been. I mean, I've been attending OAC from the day it started. So from day one, we have been hearing this: Devi should get together, agency should get together, media owners should get together. And today finally this has happened. And I think it's a great move that has happened, because today we understand where the problem lies, and we can talk to each other not as a vendor, but we're talking to each other as partners. And this is where the problem is, and hence there's a solution which is coming. The solution is easier to get rather than what we were doing for past so many years. So I think it's a great move, and to me it's going to flourish.
Mr. Bhandula.
Of course it's a landmark really which has happened. And I must really tell you that all good and quality things takes time. So if it has taken 2 years, so at least we have reached to consensus, and it's a really good move for the entire industry. It is going to benefit tremendously. The benefits you can't feel today, but yes, in the coming months, years, we haven't come across anybody who is talking like or raising any kind of questions like, you know, why you have signed this, why you have signed this. Maybe as we go along, a couple of articles might be relevant at that time. They can always be discussed and can be modified. But whatever draft and whatever agreement we have come to, it's really going to work, and it's really good for the entire industry.
Eventually, the outcome will determine how well it works. So, and one of the major outcomes would be if the industry sees growth. So from a growth perspective, how's it all going to work out, in the sense that, okay, it's great to come together and lay down the processes which are necessary, should have been done years ago. It has happened now, great. But how will that actually translate into business growth? How will you ensure that your customer is actually experiencing, it's going to be a whole new experience? And I really hope that Mr. Kapoor, the next year when we meet on a different forum, he'll say, wow, I'm actually seeing many of those things happen.
That's what my answer is going to be for Mr. Kapoor, because if he look at us like, you know, the guys are getting organized, they have certain SOPs to work within, and his confidence level is going to go up. And of course, now today you are talking 6% of your total budget, it might go to 10%, because that's how the industry is going to get benefited. So it's a start. Let's
okay.
Really,
so let's in fact. Once the SOP is implemented, and the biggest complaints of the media owners was PO on time and payments on time. I think so it's gonna, if this will come in place eventually, I think so it's gonna release a lot of cash in the system. Once the cash comes to the system, which is actually blocked with the clients or with the agencies, the media are in a position to actually invest in media. Yeah?
Oh yes.
Yeah? It is. Yeah. So we calculated that if the industry is 3,000 crores, and about 31 months of cash is released, you are actually getting 300 crores back in the system.
Yeah. Wonderful. So I'll just move to one more topic before I open this discussion and invite questions from the audience. Mr. Kapoor, now suddenly we are talking about smart cities, right? The government has planned about 100 smart cities. And somewhere along the talks about smart cities really opening up a heck of a lot of business opportunities to OOH. But really speaking, are you seeing any single opportunity for yourself?
We're seeing 100 opportunities because 100 smart cities are going to come up. And in this process, we are getting calls from the government departments to come and do a presentation and how we can improve the city, how we can regularize the media there, and how we can work with partnership so that everything is pre-planned, so that no clutter happens in the later stage. And I have personally got calls from a couple of cities where they have started this planning, and they have asked us to come and do a presentation and be a part of them in the planning stage, so that the chaos what you are seeing today in OOH doesn't happen when the cities come up.
Oh, that's really great to know that the government has actually approached you to take to hear.
And they must be approaching everybody who is part of it. I have personally done presentations at two places. Okay. So I know, and if 100 smart cities are coming in, so there is 100 more opportunities to do.
Okay. Most of my questions were not specific to Delhi NCR, but actually had its own implications for rest of the country. But let's face it that, this is the heart of the country. I think this is where policies are made. A lot of what the country will follow with actually come from what gets practiced out here. So that was one of the reasons I kept the discussion fairly broad. Now, I'll turn to the audience and invite questions. And here's the panel for you to answer your questions. Yes, Mr. Sen. You have to use the mic.
The interpretation of that policy is that if you are going to put digital, you have to pay an extra premium on your existing billboards, which none of the advertisers are right now ready to do.
No. So digital is permitted not
on on a span of 100 feet road.
Correct.
Okay, but you can't convert your existing uniposts into digital. If you have to convert that, there's an extra license fee which you need to pay on that unipole.
Yeah, so the extra license fee is fine.
But that license fee has still not been defined by the STMC.
So, but there is a provision that they have kept for.
But right now, right now, what Mr. Jha was of the opinion that we can allow it in marketplaces, not on the main roads. Although the policy has a provision.
Yeah, so that's part of our agenda to take up with him now.
Yes.
More questions? Yes.
Hi everyone. So this is a very generic kind of question because all the big shots of outdoor industry are sitting out here, and my question is something related to the presentation of Mr. Kapoor. So the thing is ki you guys are saying ki you guys want to really grow the pie from brand side, and for that you guys are willing to consolidate, work on a common platform, do consolidated bidding and all those things. But point is ki if you are asking brand to give you more money, there are a few things which brand is asking for. The bottom line of what Kapoor's presentation was ki, are we getting ROI? And right now the thing is ki, all of you big guys are working with separate agencies, research companies for validation of saying ki, this site is good, this property is good, this area is good. But everyone is working differently. Right now the point is there is no central point which can me as a brand tell me ki, okay, if I want to reach 18 to 34 SACA. The first answer which I will get from any agency is Cyber Hub. Point is, Cyber Hub is too costly for me. Limited inventory, I can't be present out there. What's the next best option? Frankly, no answer. Then it will be like, sir, aap sector 29 mein try karke dekh lijiye. Aap South X try kar sakte hain. But the point is ki, if I compare this thing very similar to, if I say TV. Point is ki, there I have an option of picking the genres, picking the channels. If I am not going ahead with Star Movies, I have an option of going ahead with HBO because they are somehow defining their TG, they are somehow able to tell me ki, this TG you can reach out somewhere. But the point with outdoor is ki, all of you guys are working with big research agencies on your different parts, but no one is trying to consolidate that. One agency comes to me with saying ki, mere paas Nielsen ki study hai. दूसरी आती है मेरे पास कि मेरे पास जीएफ के मोड है. तीसरा मेरे पास आएगा कि मेरे पास आईएमआरबी की स्टडी है. बट द पॉइंट इज कि एम आई गोइंग टू बिलीव ऑल थ्री गाइज बिकॉज वन गाय इज टेलिंग मी कि साउथ एक्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ वैल्यू फॉर मनी इज नॉट गुड बिकॉज साइट कॉस्ट इज वेरी हाई. अदर पीपल कम्स टू मी स्टेटिंग कि सर साउथ एक्स में आपका धंधा बहुत अच्छा होता है वहाँ पे. बट नो वन इज गिविंग मी अ ग्राउंड वेयर स्टेटिंगली आई कैन से कि ओके विच साइट is really good for me. Because what happens after that, ki Delhi, I can still say, ki, okay, main khud jaake dekh raha hu, wahan pe everything is done. For some other cities, I am totally reliant on my city teams. And it might be ki, the options which I get, I share with my city teams, I get their feedback. And many times, even those feedbacks are really bad because those guys are not expert in outdoor.
So quite a pertinent question you have raised actually. It's not a question of actually per se the outdoor site. It's a question of the location which you are going to pick up for your brand. And if the location has that particular site, then I think so it can address the relevant TG. But yes, now I think so. Mr. Sen, I think so. We've been talking about research.
Yeah. May I
intervene?
Intervene. I'm really kind of very grateful that you raised this question, okay? Because at IOAA, we have been trying to explain this need to our community and the entire ecosystem for years now, and we have been talking about this every year, but unfortunately we have not never gone in, gone anywhere. And the reason, there are reasons for it. The kind of research that tells you about reach and frequency for outdoor entails, firstly, a site-wise rating. Now that is the first thing that all our media companies are very scared of, because a site rating might render half your sites to be not as valuable as you are trying to create, you know, say it is now. On the other hand, what they're ignoring is that the other half might be even more valuable than what they are trying to place it today. But this lack of this confidence is preventing a lot of media companies from going ahead and accepting a site rating that needs to be done as part of this entire study. The second part of it is regulation related. If you have a 1 year or a 2 year or even a 3 year contract, yeah, it doesn't give you enough time to really place your media correctly so that the maximum value is obtained for it. Now, we as an organization are, I mean, as an association of the media companies are faced with these challenges to convince people. It was said that, you know, we need about 20 crores or something like that for many cities. We can do this city by city at a much lesser cost. In our discussion with the agencies, we have also agreed on a way of raising this money by taking a certain percentage of the total bill and parking that aside as a you know, as a cost for the analytics. Okay, so there it, that is not an impossibility or anything like that. The positive factor that has been achieved till date is what I would like to tell you is by having finally having this SOP on board, where at least the agencies and the clients and the media has come together, there is at least some realization that an organized way of working pays and pays profitably, rather than continuing with chaotic ways of working without any rules of the game at all. Once this has been achieved, we hope that now the next step, that a little more order and a little more proper research and planning will also work, will be realized, and then we can go to the next step. But till then, whatever you're saying will remain a wishful thinking. We all wish that we had this, but nothing is going to move until, you know, these things are all resolved.
So my basic issue out here is ki, like what Mr. Kapoor was telling is exactly correct. If I have a certain budget, frankly, the point is ki, my top management doesn't question me in terms of TV planning or radio planning, because they know very well ki, there is a set standard out there, there's fixed numbers, we are doing it from long time, we know how this is going to work. The moment it comes to outdoor, we are more than willing to increase the budget for radio, we are willing to increase budget for TV. But the moment it comes on to outdoor, the outdoor budget is always slashed and move on to these things. Whereas as per TGI data, your outdoor is the second biggest medium post TV, which covers maximum population. Still, that number is not good enough to give confidence to marketing guys like Mr. Kapoor or me, or to defend those plans. Because frankly, no one is willing to defend a plan where I am putting almost a crore on Delhi. And end result mere paas kya aayega ki sir dikha bahut acha tha, but wo dikha bahut acha tha meri ROI ki sheet mein nahi dikh raha hai. So I am with radio, I am still fine ki okay, I have some numbers, they might be vague, but I still have something on paper. So till the time I don't have that backing, there is a certain point till which a marketeer can push. Beyond that push, it will be the, we are working on that same number, that same buy is going from one agency to another agency, one agency is growing at the cost of degrowth of other agency, because your pie is not increasing. So overall it might be ki you are growing, but overall kahan?
Sir, this is the same thing that we are all hearing for the last so many years. Every year, every 6 months or 3 months, whenever we have a gathering, we are all hearing the same thing. And the fact of the matter also is that even though we have a year-on-year 10-11% growth, our share of the overall pie is reducing every year over the last 4 to 5 years, and currently it is hovering only around 5.5% from a percentage figure which used to be in excess of 9 at one point of time. So this is the same thing that we're hearing over and over again. We're from clients, big, small, medium, but we have yet to get ourselves out of this lethargy that we are happy with this 10% growth here. Forget about the industry. As a company, I am happy with the 10% growth. Forget the industry is going down or whatever is happening, okay? Because there are always someone or the other who will invest in your media. So you are getting that 10% growth. So until everyone comes together and looks at the industry perspective and adheres to sticking together and go moving ahead and accepts the fact that that is the way, nothing will happen. Agencies are happy with the way things are happening. Media is happy with the way things are happening. Until both agencies and media come together to say that, no, we will not work without Netflix, things are not going to move.
All right. I think on that particular subject, you know, a day will be too less to discuss because it's such a topic on which has been discussed for years. Hopefully, we'll see much more action on that count. I have to bring this session to a close, but before I do that, I would like the panelists to individually suggest two things that need to be done for OOH to double itself in the Delhi NCR. Mr. Kapoor, you can start with two things you can suggest.
See, the first thing is what Mr. Sen also said, and everybody is feeling, is that we don't have a currency. The moment we have that currency, we have the numbers, the 6% grows to 10%, and then overall 10% growth of the industry, yeah, and see the kind of volumes we grow into. So once those things come into place, which everybody is lacking, and everybody is doing an individual effort to give those authenticity and numbers, what he said, that everybody is coming with their numbers, but they are not certified numbers. So once we have certified numbers, then we are sitting on a gold mine. And then from 6%, we have 4%, and then 10% of the entire thing, and then you see how we grow.
All right.
From my side, I think so digital is the way forward. Digital is the way forward for Delhi, I guess.
Yeah.
To me, I think the city is too crowded. So the multiple, there is a supply chain is not restricted. Until unless that is restricted, it is not going to see really the light of day. Uniformity, as we all agree. So as a client, Sanu, you have heard from the client side also. The uniformity is the most important part which plays to benefit the industry, and aesthetically your city looks beautiful, and we are one of the major component which gives a feel to the city. Like, you know, if you go to Kolkata, you come back and say, oh, it's a billboard city. I mean, like, you know, I mean, you have nothing to talk about. You go to any of the European city or any good city, or maybe in the Asian countries, and you go to small cities, you got to feel like, you know, while walking on the pavement or something. So it's very, very important, and that is who? We are the people, those who are going to really put in capex, R&D, lobby with the city. City would love to, and our major responsibility which we are lacking as an industry, that it's our responsibility to educate the city bosses. They have 100 things other. They have basics to really address the sewage, water, electricity, and I think it's the last priority for them. We as a citizens, we as a responsible industry guys, we have to go and lobby and to educate them. Like, this is what is good for you, not that under the name of wall wrap we'll rape the city. Let's not do that.
So common currency, uniformity, advocacy, 3 points. Dipankar.
Under the given circumstances, what we have right now, if I'm taking this as a currency, I think two things. One would be rate correction. Second would be a common currency for measurability. I think under the given circumstances, these two can foster growth for Delhi NCR.
Fantastic. Great takeaways.
Rajiv,
before you close, I have one last question to close, if you
allow me one last question.
Surely, please. I think we'll allow two questions because Satya is also going
to
ask.
First of all, to be very quick, I must thank the gentleman over there from Intex. You spoke like one of the media owners rather than being a client. Exactly. Many questions what you said are the pains that we take. And thank you for such a wonderful session. I have a very brief question for the esteemed panel. The panel consists of the media owners also and agencies also and two in one also. Right. So let's have a funny end to the evening. hum log sab bade hue hain ye sunke jiski laathi uski bhains. I have only one question to ask. Somebody has talked about monopoly, monopolization. Somebody has talked about cartel. Somebody has talked about association. I have only one question to ask. Sir, if my media is for 10 rupees, who gave the right to one agency to market it for 9 rupees, other for 7.5 rupees, third for 7.65 rupees, some for 8 plus 2, some for 7 plus 3. IOAA is doing all to get the media recognized. I would like the agency heads over here very seriously to ask, is there a rule of governance for the agency also to procure business? Because such steps would give the birth to illegality, give the birth to illegal medias. Let's not run away from that responsibility. Rome was not broken down in a day. Illegal media would not have come up had the agency support not been there. So if there was a discussion about Delhi, all my media owner partners here have been saying this, but I had the courage to get up and tell this on the mic. The agency has to take leadership today, has to take responsibility that yes, we should have a rule of governance amongst ourselves. Sir, let's have a joyful end to the evening. Let's go out laughing before the drinks set in. The agency part consolidation of the rules of governance has to be a part of some SOP, some agenda. Maybe we leap forward to the next year of discussions. But yes, the thought should start now.
Mr. Luthra, thank you very much for a brilliant question.
Sir, you accept my points? Sir, I was shocked when I got a booking for 6 plus 4 days. Sir, iske liye kaun si neend ki dawai bani mujhe yeh samajh mein nahi aaya.
Okay, let's hear Dipankar's view.
To answer that, let me put it this way. Somebody allowed it to happen somewhere, because of which rest took it up and pushed it forward. No, it's not past. At the end of the day, what was in the past, that's continuing into the future. So somebody allowed it somewhere, and it has happened, and it continues. So it's in the hand of the media owners to put a stop to it. It's up to you. You put a stop to it. If you continue to allow this to happen, this will happen. Let me put it this way. If you put a stop to it, if you say, I will not accept it, I am ready to let go of the business, I will suffer for 1 month, let the agency also suffer. If you're ready to take the risk, it will stop.
We make agencies the villains, but media owners are the biggest villains. They are engaged in internecine war and they harm them.
Absolutely.
And they blame the agency.
Just a second, I'll answer. So, what Shashi said, but Shashi, it's not the end there. If I were to refuse that booking will be shifted to some other media owner because he is willing to give
Pawan sir, I'll just ask my question more correctly or just one on one. A Unipol is there in Southex. Saare 7 lakh rupay ka hai because it is standard, whatever cost, whatever acquisition price, forget it. A wall wrap is behind that. Some good friend of mine, yeah, 5 lakh rupay ka de de. Wall wrap hai, rooftop hai, abhi Bandula sahab ne bola, jo bhi hai, kuch bhi hai. Agar ek rule of governance bane, if there's an SOP on that if it is not a permitted site, not X type of site, take it. It has to be from both the sides. One media owner who has taken a tender, my friend Amit is sitting there, I know how much pain he has right now. And I can see that. It is not one-sided traffic, sir. It has to be both ways movement. So what happens in the eyes of the client, we have no rates. That media outdoor, yeah, unka to koi rate hi nahi hai. 7.5 lakh, वहीं पे तो मेरे को 3.5 lakh रुपए का माल मिल गया, हड़के चलान नहीं आते. So the rule of governance has to begin from both sides. That is what I feel, that is what few of my friends also feel, and I think some serious thought on that has to begin.
Luthra ji, why we are surviving is because MDNC, SDMC has not allowed billboards.
Absolutely correct.
If they allow, if the policy changes there and the wall wraps come in, we will be also...
All of us.
Everybody will have to... Unless and until the policies are implemented, and now on the first question also, if the SOPs have been formed, they were formed earlier also, if they will not be implemented, then what is the point of forming those SOPs? And what will happen is, as Mr. Ritesh told, that there are a lot of black sheep in Delhi, in outdoor, and more number are in Delhi. Ultimately, in coming years, those black sheep will be part of that IOA, and all these SOPs will be left behind. And the market share, what we have reached, 5% from 9%, will go to 2%. Instead of increasing that market share from 5% to 9%.
In a way, you are also saying what I feel, that yes, a rule of governance has to be made. Okay, yes. This is legal.
Yes.
We will support this as an agency also, and we will recommend this to our clients.
See, why doesn't IOA steps in when they find an illegal hoarding? Why the crisis happens? The crisis only happens when a lot of illegal things happen. And why those things are happening? Nobody checks. When it goes beyond a point, the government will come and they will try and remove everything. What is happening in UP now? What happened in Delhi earlier? Unless and until IOA or any body takes a stand and say this is right, this is wrong, nothing is going to happen, and we are going to lose the market share.
That is why we went into the High Court for the first time.
All right. I think we still have a lot of things ahead of us. One last question.
I would like to thank my friends from the kind fraternity, Mr. Dheeraj, Mr. Amit. I think you opened it up completely. Amazing discussion. But I want to share something with you which happened in the morning today. We had a gentleman called Mr. David Pine. He was sharing the global story. The global story is what you are saying. I mean, it's music to my ears when I hear that it's going to be next to television in terms of, but then we are not there. I mean, 3,000 crores, it pains to all of us sitting here. But then he says the global story is 44% of the overall pie, which they are foreseeing. So everybody is sitting here. If you can put things together, all of us are sitting in a gold mine. I think with all good heads putting together, we'll come to that place. So I think we'll end up with a good note.
Fantastic. So thank you very much for a very good panel discussion and for your valuable participation in this discussion. Well, that's all we had for today.